to 11.
That's not a very long time.
It's 11 seconds. What is the right way to run 100 metres?
Look at the body, look at this old Madison running, I think.
When you're in the Olympic game final with seven other girls who can run just as fast as you, anything can happen.
The 100 meter sprint has three main phases. It's start and acceleration when athletes increase their velocity. At the start of the race, you try to get your foot very quickly in contact that you can actually push again and again. They can increase the velocity only when they are in contact with the ground.
The angle of displacement of a body needs to be gradual, and provided arms are moving very quick, she should be able to come up similar to a plane. What that is doing is building momentum in the accelerated phase to hopefully get to top end speed.
Then there's a maximum velocity phase. When foot comes to the contact with the ground, there's always a little bit of braking. These two phases, braking phase and a push-off phase, are equal as an impulse, and athlete cannot increase the velocity. All this happens in less than a blink of an eye. At that point, they move over 10 meters per second. There's a deceleration phase towards the end of the race, where it looks like the better athletes accelerate away from the other athletes. But in fact, they decelerate the least.
The ones that are able to get to the speed and then hold on to the speed are the ones that win. Because there's always going to be a technical and a muscular breakdown in everybody's running.
All this that you've trained for is like, it's just like a big exhale, like literally, it's 11 seconds. We train 6 days a week when we want to, when we don't want to. You just have to come to training no matter what.
Athletes train something called muscle memory. So that's the combination of neural system and a muscle working together to create this movement. And when it has been repeated enough times, it starts to move back of the brain and it becomes automated movement. The brain sends the signals towards the muscles. There's an electrical current going through the nervous system, which then reaches the muscle and releases calcium, which then allows the muscles to contract.
Research shows that if you want to tell the body to do it differently, you've got to do 200 to 500 attempts of doing the right stuff. So you get to a stage where it becomes what you call a controlled reflex action.
There you go.
During the race, Ashley needs to concentrate on her own performance. If she starts to think about what's happening around her and the other athletes, she starts to give the mixed messages to her body.
On race day, with all the anxiety and adrenaline, my mind almost goes blank. Now I'm a little bit older, I managed to just calm everything down and I think about my process. First thing I have to do is move my arms. I don't think about what my legs are doing. For me, the faster I move my arms, the faster I move my legs. It's taken me a while to figure out just little cues that are best for me, really. 100 metres in the Olympic Stadium is 100 metres at Lee Valley, is 100 metres at wherever. You just have to think like that. I always go back to process because that shouldn't change. The main part of sprinting is, can you do it when it really matters? When you're in the final with seven other girls who can run just as fast as you. That's why they say, I just want to make it to the final and then anything can happen. And it's true. It's so true. Oh, it's so true. It's actually really exciting.
Set.